I'm Harlan Charles, Corvette Product Manager from Chevrolet, and today I'm going to talk about the first generation Corvette, the one that started it all. The 1953 Corvette was shown as a show car at the Motorama at the Waldorf Astoria in New York in early 1953, and it really became a sensation.
This Chevrolet Corvette and the other customized models are not for sale yet. They were built to give tangible form to the drawing board ideas of today, out of which may grow the shape of things to come.
It really was a beautiful car for its day. It had a lot of influence from European sports cars at the time. Seeing that car was Zora Arcostanto, who became Corvette's legendary chief engineer. He was inspired that he thought he could take this car, make it into a world-class sports car that could take on the best from Europe and win. Over the life cycle of the first generation, we went from a pretty car to a car which had the coves on the side and a lot more dynamic character, which really made the car look like it was moving when standing still. Engine-wise, the 1953 Corvette was actually introduced with the Blue Flame straight six-cylinder engine that was used in a lot of the Chevrolet lineup at that time, boosted up to 150 horsepower. Now, we knew that was going to cut it for a sports car, so in 1955, the first of the Chevrolet small block V8s was introduced, 265 cubic inch at 55, which really took the performance to a new level. And in 1957, the engine was boosted up to 283 cubic inches and 283 horsepower with fuel injection, which really hit the magic 1 horsepower per cubic inch number for the first time. 1960, we took our America sports car over to Europe to race at the 24-hour Le Mans race for the first time, and it won its class, really creating the legacy of Corvette racing that we have today. Second generation Corvette.
There are two Stingray models. First, the Corvette convertible, and second, the new Corvette Sport Coupe.
Second generation Corvette, known as the Corvette Stingray. And how that happened is Vice President of Design Bill Mitchell did a lot of deep sea fishing in Florida and was really impressed with the shape of the Stingray as it swam in the ocean. That influence became part of the body design of the 59 race car Corvette Stingray, which ultimately became influenced into the 1963 Corvette Stingray, including the split window design, the coupe, adding the coupe to the portfolio, and things like that. And it really became the Stingray generations, which ran from 1963 to 1967. In the second generation Corvette, the engine lineup expanded. We ended up having the big block V8 come out in 1965, and in 66, it went up to 427 cubic inches, which became a magic number with the performance community. And I'm standing next to is a 1967 427 Corvette Stingray.
The most exciting hardtop model you ever laid eyes on. It'll be a pace setter for years to come.
Third generation Corvette was introduced in 1968 and was the longest running of the generations and went all the way to 1982 and really saw the most variation in times and culture and the way people thought about the Corvette. It started in 68, late 60s, big high horsepower era, went all the way up to the 454 V8 in 1970. Racing kept going with Corvette. Car was raced at Sebring. A lot of people remember those glorious Greenwood Corvettes, the real thunderous presence that they had. Then you went through the 70s where we were concerned about the gas crisis, fuel economy, emission controls came on, so the Corvette became cleaner and more efficient. The car was really well received as the styling statement was very radical, a lot lower and a little bit longer. The design was really influenced by the Mako Shark show car in 1965. One of the things that happened during the Corvette's third generation, 1978, the 25th anniversary of Corvette, and they celebrated it with a special silver anniversary edition and also an Indianapolis pace car replica, and those became some of the most collectible Corvettes of that generation. This is the shape a lot of people think of. You close your eyes, you say the word Corvette, this is the car and the shape that pops into your head. The fourth generation came out as a 1984 model and ran all the way through to 1996. The 1984 Corvette really put an emphasis on aerodynamics. And with a 0.34 drag coefficient, it's still a figure that's pretty good even for today's standards. We added a lot of technology, things like anti-lock brakes, traction control, one flat tires. Another interesting thing, 84 Corvette had all electronic instrumentation, very far ahead of its time. 1984 Corvette introduced a new feature that we still have today, and that is the one-piece removable roof panel on the coupe, which really gives the coupe convertible functionality. One piece, and it fits in the cargo area in the back. One of the unique features that's exclusive to the fourth generation Corvette is this clamshell design hood. And you can see you really get a good access to the engine, the tires, the suspension A-arms, and it really was a wow feature when this came out. Also through the life cycle, in 1990, the mighty ZR1 was introduced, which had 375 horsepower. That car set a 24-hour endurance record, averaging over 180 miles an hour, a record that stood for 12 years. Also on the racing front, the Corvette competed in the SCCA Showroom Stock Endurance Challenge and went undefeated to the point where they actually took the Corvette out of that series and created a unique Corvette Challenge series being run by factory-prepared race cars. The fifth generation Corvette, aka C5, introduced in 97, ran all the way to 2004. One of the neat things about the fifth generation Corvette, you see the huge amount of trunk space that it has, which really took the Corvette into a level where you'd use it as your daily driver, use it for long distance trips. And how we did that, we moved the transmission to the rear and had split fuel tanks, one behind each seat, which really lowered the cargo floor and allowed for more space. Also, the higher rear, which helps cargo space, was really done for aerodynamics on the racetrack. Another neat thing about the Corvette, continued the small block, came out with 345 horsepower. 2002 Z06 model upped it all the way to 405 horsepower as well. Some of the technology we saw, active handling, stability control come out, the head-up display, which projects your speed and other data right onto the windshield like a jet fighter. And all Corvettes were introduced with run-flat tires. So a lot of technology in this car. Racing. Corvette, very successful in racing. We started the Corvette Racing Factory Back team, won at Le Mans three times, won the ALMS Manufactured Championship four times. And the fifth generation Corvette was really a reinvention of the Corvette in many ways. It has a new type of structure, hydroformed steel structure, really reduced a lot of parts, was really lightweight and strong, had really good functionality and passenger space for a sports car. Sixth generation Corvette, introduced in 2005, really had an emphasis on making the car leaner and meaner. A lot of effort on making the car more compact, 5 inches shorter than the previous generation, shorter overall length than a Porsche 911, and a lot of work done to make the car lightweight. In 2006, on the Z06 model, introduced the aluminum frame and carbon fiber panels. 2009, we had the mighty ZR1, reintroduced with a 638 horsepower supercharged V8. And then for 2013, to celebrate our 60th anniversary, we have this new 427 convertible, which features the LS7 engine from the Z06 for the first time in a Corvette convertible, creating the ultimate convertible. It has features like carbon fiber hood, fenders, ground effects, four panels, and has a magnetic selective ride control, ZR1 tires, really the ultimate Corvette convertible for the 60th anniversary.